Guys, what is going on? I wanted to take a little bit here, do a video and show you the upgrades and give you some ideas of things that I've done to this CZ Scorpion Evo 3 S2 Micro. Now, this is one of my favorite guns. Just the ergonomics, the way it feels, just love it. The ammo capability that you can put in there. You can get 50 round drums. Right now it's got 35 round P mags in it. Now, with that being said, even though it is one of my favorite firearms, there is some things that I did want to do to upgrade this. And probably the main reason to do some upgrades, somebody was asking me, why would you buy a firearm that's that expensive and then have to do work to the trigger? Well, the thing is, guys, is these guns in a different barrel length configuration are made for the Czech military, and they are made to be fired and used full auto. When they put in the full auto trigger, that trigger is going to be a little bit different than what we have here in semi-automatic firearms. It had a real heavy reset, so when you were on the juice and you were letting them bullets rip and you let up, the thing was quick to stop firing. The trigger pull was a little bit heavier. It's built to be a submachine gun, but it's shipped here semi-automatic with the same trigger pack, but you can't fire full auto. So that's the reason why an expensive firearm like this has a trigger pull that needs a little bit done to it. And it was very cheap. I'll get into that in a minute here. Let's go ahead and talk about some of the things I did that you can see, and then we'll talk about things I did that you can't see. A lot of these parts came from HB Industries, guys, right here if you want to know. I just happened to find this because I was looking online at different things, and there were so many guys that own these talking about this company, and this company has some of the best aftermarket parts for the CZ Scorpion that I've seen online. So HB Industries is where most of this stuff came from. Now let's talk about the grip. This is the Magpul grip. I love the ergonomics of this now. The stock grip would have been just like this that you see here. I'm holding it against the frame, and I'm holding it in the same position that it would have been if it were on this firearm. And look at the difference. Look at the angle and the difference that there was between these two. Now, with this grip, it's much better. The gun feels much better to me, and it's much more ergonomic than it was before. Also, as you guys know, I bought some Magpul 35-round magazines. You can get these for like $14.99 online. So, really good deal on magazines. I love that. It's not like something like the SIG MPX, which I like too. But the SIG MPX magazines, you're not getting any good cheap deals on. So, let's talk about the second thing I did, which is something that you can see on the outside. Now, I shoot left-handed. So, you would just reverse this if you're a right-handed shooter. This is the what they call the AK style safety, and I love it. There it would be on safe, and if you have this gun on a sling or you bring it up to fire, all you would do is your trigger finger would come in, and when it brushes up against that, it can click it off. Very positive feeling, very nice click. Guys, I couldn't be happier with this HB Industries AK style safety lever. I left the original on the other side, but this thing is just pretty amazing here. So if you were on safe like this, you can feel it, even if it was dark, before you put your finger in that trigger guard, all you got to do is just brush up a little bit and it's off safe, and it's completely out of the way of my trigger finger. So you can see the difference of how that took this away, this piece that hangs down. And people complain that when you fire, if you fire with your finger on the same side as this, it rubs your finger. Well, that's never going to happen now with this AK style safety. The only time it's in the way here is when it's on safe, and that's fine, because then you're going to come in anytime you want to get into that trigger, just bump it up and you can start firing. So it's really an amazing upgrade, guys. Well worth the money. Another thing I did, guys, was I changed out the trigger shoe. It had a curved style trigger like most firearms come with, and I put in this HBI Industries flat face trigger, which is going to make your trigger pull feel a little bit lighter than it already is. Just with the flat wide face like that, it just has that effect to it. when you pull it. I really like that trigger. It was easy to put in there. You take the trigger pack out, you push a roll pin out, and you can take off the curved style factory trigger, and you can put in this flat-faced wide trigger like that. Now, probably the biggest change to this firearm is going to be one that you can't even see, and that is the change to the trigger pull. I put in a spring kit from HB Industries, and I believe it was $10 is all that I paid for that spring kit. It was pretty easy to install. There was one part of it that was kind of tough. You have a spring you have to push down while you're adding a part back in on top of it. Other than that, everything on the trigger pack and taking it apart was very easy, and all the other parts were easy as well. Let me go ahead and show you the trigger pull. Let me take out this magazine. We're gonna clear the gun. And I'm gonna go ahead and show you what that trigger pull looks like now. It reduced it to about half of the weight that it was when it came from factory. Very nice trigger. Let me show you the reset. Here's the pull. Man, nice, crisp trigger. Real happy with that, guys. I have no issues, concerns, or problems with that whatsoever. The last 2 weekends, I had planned to take this out and shoot it and get videos. And guess what? Something came up. I wasn't feeling well this last weekend. And the weekend before, something came up and I couldn't make it out to the range either, or to the place I go, to relatives where I shoot. But I do planning on getting this out there very soon. And I've got, you know, at least about 200 to 250 rounds I'm going to put through it in the first session there. I've got everything Loctited. Everything that was put back together is Loctited. Another thing I want to get for this is the Hollow Sun. I believe it's called the HS510C. It looks like a reflex style sight. It does have the quick attach lever, and it has a window almost like an EOTech, and it has a reticle kind of like the EOTech with the 65 MOA ring, the 2 MOA dot. You can make the outer ring disappear and just use the 2 MOA dot, or you can make the dot disappear and just use the bigger ring for up close, fast target shooting. Also, it has a solar panel, and it can use that energy when you're shooting outdoors instead of the battery. The battery lasts about 5 years, but my favorite features of that Hollow Sun HS510C is what's called the shake awake. So you just leave the reflex sight on. Whenever you pick up this gun or even bump it, before you get this up to your eyes, that reflex sight is going to be on. It also has auto dim and auto brightness. Depending on what lighting that you're in, the actual reticle will get dimmer or brighter depending on the lighting it sees through the solar panel. It's $309. It's about the cheapest I can find it right now. And that's definitely the red dot sight that I want to put on this. This firearm is now much closer to where that I want it to be, with just these few little upgrades. Didn't cost very much money at all, but it's very much closer to being perfect for the way that I wanna run it. So there's my Scorpion Micro so far. Let me know what you guys think, and if you have any ideas or anything, or if you have this firearm and you've done something to it and you think I should look into it, post it in the comments below. And until next time, guys, this is DOF, and I am out.